So, which are the main three types of electromagnetic wave propagation? Can you tell me? Yes. Nikhil, can you tell me what are the different three types of electromagnetic wave propagation? So, when I call you, please switch on your audio and answer. Okay, your answer may be correct or wrong, sir. That is a different story, but give me the answer.
Is
Manish is here.
propagation
Okay. Space propagation. Then, what else? Space propagation.
इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक प्रोपोगेशन था सर.
वही मतलब व्हाट फर्स्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम आस्किंग कि व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द टेली कम्युनिकेशन राइट सो मीन्स विद द इन टेली कम्युनिकेशन देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन आर देर वन इज अ वायर्ड अनदर वन इज अ ऑप्टिकल एंड थर्ड वन इज अ वायरलेस कम्युनिकेशन राइट सो दीज थ्री मेजर टाइप्स आर देर सो वी आर मच मोर इंटरेस्टेड इन वायरलेस कम्युनिकेशन बिकॉज Our subject that is propagation and microwave techniques is related with the electromagnetic wave propagation. So, what was my question? Ki I simply ask you, ki what are the different types of
रेडियो
electromagnetic wave propagation?
वेव्स माइक्रोवेव्स
Radio,
इन्फ्रारेड रेडिएशन
and microwave. Radio wave.
लॉस तो सीरीज मध्ये असतो.
हाँ लेकिन रेडियो
ठीक
वेव
है
एंड
मागे
माइक्रो
वाजता पण झोपलोय बघ.
यस यस रेडियो वेव एंड माइक्रोवेव इज नथिंग बट दीज आर द
आता
टाइप्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव ओके आई एम आस्किंग
जॉईन करायचं आणि ठेवायचं.
यस देयर इज अ बॅकग्राउंड साउंड निखिल
काय झालं काय?
ओके ओके निखिल ऑडियो ऑफ कर दो तुम्हारा ओके सो जस्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन कि देर आर मेजर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन सो थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव प्रोपोगेशन इंस्टेड ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन व्हाट आई कैन से प्रोपोगेशन वन इज द स्काई वेव प्रोपोगेशन सेकेंड वन दैट इज द स्पेस वेव प्रोपोगेशन एंड थर्ड वन दैट इज द ग्राउंड वेव प्रोपोगेशन सो वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट दिस इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर So here, just within a second, just we will take the review. So here, this is the first type means transmitter receiver. We are transmitting the electromagnetic wave. So here, this electromagnetic wave can be transferred. This electromagnetic wave can be transferred with the help of this transmitter antenna and receiver antenna, right? So, but when we are transmitting this electromagnetic wave, we can transmit this electromagnetic wave by using the three types. And which one is suitable for our electromagnetic wave? So it will depend upon the frequency of that electromagnetic wave. Means what I mean to say that ki this electromagnetic wave is having suppose low frequency. So we know that ki there are three types. One is a ground wave. Ground wave communication, second one is the sky wave communication, and third one that is the space wave communication. So from these three, which one is suitable for my communication? What is the condition? Ki my electromagnetic wave is having lower frequency. So we know that in ground wave communication is suitable for the lower frequency. Okay. So we already seen about this one. Ground wave communication, it is suitable for the lower frequency. If the frequency is higher one, then we will go for the sky wave communication. So in sky wave communication, we are using the atmospheric layers, that is the ionosphere. So these layers are located between 65 kilometers to 400 kilometers above the curvature of Earth. Or in other words, we can say it will be located above the surface of Earth. Means from 0 kilometer to 65 kilometer, this area is suitable for the ground wave communication, and above 65 to 400, so this area is suitable for the sky wave communication. The lower one, this one, in ground wave communication, this type of communication is suitable for the lower frequency, and 65 to 400, this area is suitable for the medium frequency. And if the frequencies are above some megahertz, okay, means for kilohertz, we can say it is suitable for ground wave. For megahertz, we can say that it is suitable for sky wave. And the electromagnetic wave, who are having the frequency in gigahertz, so for that, we have the space wave communication. In space wave communication, we know that there is a satellite who receives the signal, amplify it, and send back to the receiver station. Okay. So these are the different three major ways of electromagnetic wave propagation: ground, sky, and space. So this we already discussed in previous lecture. Okay. So now here, up till now, here we are talking about the electromagnetic waves core component, that is the frequency, wavelength, and speed of light. These three major parameters of electromagnetic wave. Again, these electromagnetic wave having the two types of energy: magnetic energy and electrical energy. Magnetic energy is perpendicular to the electrical energy, right? So this is another important point. Third point is that these waves are propagated in three ways: ground, sky, and space. Okay, so this is the communication of electromagnetic wave between transmitter and receiver. Now, from today onwards, we will focus on the core part. Okay, so these things we already seen. I'm going to skip it. Now, the next thing is that we are going to see the actual electromagnetic wave propagation. Okay, with the help of antenna. So first we will see what do you mean by radiation and radiation mechanism. So these two things we have to see. First one, that is the radiation, and second one, that is the radiation mechanism. And the third thing is that with the help of this radiation mechanism, how we can transmit the electromagnetic waves. Okay, so what is radiation? We know that radiation is nothing but it is a transmission of energy from some source to destination in the form of electromagnetic wave. Okay, that is a radiation. Radiation mechanism. So radiation mechanism is nothing but, so these are the tools. These are the tools these are the different mechanisms which are used to transmit this electromagnetic wave. Means in radiation mechanism, we have to study that which tools we are using to transmit this electromagnetic wave, right? So that is the second thing, right? So focusing on electromagnetic radiation, focusing on electromagnetic radiation, we have to see one important equation, that is the Faraday's equation. So in Faraday's equation, what we have to do, first we have to understood free space, right? So means free space means we know that these electromagnetic waves are propagated or travel through atmosphere. So there are two terms. When these electromagnetic wave travel in atmosphere, and when these electromagnetic wave travel in free space, what is the difference between free space and atmosphere? Yes, so first we have to understand this term. What do you mean by free space? So here on your screen you can see that this free space is nothing but it is one type of medium where there is no atmosphere. So what do you mean by no atmosphere? Means it doesn't have any atmospheric layers, or it doesn't have different types of gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, or ozone. means it is nothing is there. Means in simple language, what we can say that there is no disturbance. No ionization layers are there. No ionization layers are available. Means totally blank body, right? Or we can say it is like a black body, zero interference. Okay, so such type of atmosphere, it means such type of medium where nothing is present. So that is nothing, but we call it as a free space. Okay, means see it means if on your screen you can observe that it does not interfere with the normal radiation and propagation of radio wave. Is there is a no interference. Second point is that it has no magnetic or gravitational field. So we know that in atmosphere we have the gravitational field and we have the magnetic field. So this gravitational field is coming from the gravity of Earth, right? And magnetic field is coming from the light which is emitted by the sun. Means we have the electromagnetic light. So because of that, it will generate the magnetic field. Okay. And third one, it doesn't have no solid bodies. So what it means to say that with our naked eyes, we cannot observe any solid bodies in atmosphere. But there are small particles are there. So with the help of microscope, we can observe those particles. But in free space, no such bodies are available. And last one, that is, it has no ionized particle. Ionized particle means, what is the difference between solid body and ionized particle? In solid bodies, they doesn't have any charge. But ionized particles are those particles means they may have some solid bodies, but they are carrying some amount of charge. It may be positive charge or it may be negative charge. Okay. So if these four conditions are satisfied by that medium, so that in that scenario we will call it as a free space. So what is the first condition? It doesn't have any interference. Second condition, it doesn't have any magnetic or gravitational field. Third condition, it doesn't have any solid bodies. And fourth condition is that it doesn't have any ionized particle. So if such a medium is there, so that medium is nothing but we called it as a free space. Right. So now the thing is that why there is need to study free space. So first of all, we have to understood that whether the free space is actually or practically available. Can you give me the answer? When we are going for the electromagnetic wave propagation or electromagnetic wave transmission. So on practical ground, whether the free space is available, yes or no? Yes, can anybody tell me whether the free space is available practically? Yes, Madhura, can you tell me? So practically whether free space is available? Or anybody can answer? Practically please.
Yes, sir.
Ravi bole, practically whether the free space is available?
Yes, sir.
Kahan par hota hai?
Space mein.
Space mein, but in just space, we have the electromagnetic waves, hai na? We have the ultraviolet light, which is coming from sun. Okay, but in our condition, what we say that it has no magnetic field. Magnetic or gravitational field. It has no magnetic field, but these electromagnetic waves generate the magnetic field. Okay, so such conditions are not available practically. Okay, so what you have means now the question, second question is arise that sir, if the practical conditions, practically this free space is not at all available, so why are we supposed to study this? So the answer is that for the electromagnetic wave propagation, we will consider these terms and conditions for the electromagnetic waves, and it will take as a standard. Okay, means it will refer. So we will take this condition as a reference line. We will consider this condition as a zero. Okay, if there is no interference, no magnetic field, no solid bodies or no ionized particle. So if such a medium is there, we call it as a free space or zero reference level. But practically it is not available means definitely there are some solid bodies, there is some magnetic field or there is some interference, right? So in such scenario, we will take this free space as a reference level, right? So this is the first condition. Whether my voice is audible to you? Hello? Okay. So such conditions are known as a free space. Okay. Now second thing is that here isotropic source. Okay. So isotropic source means what? Okay. So that we have to study means when we are going to study the Faraday's law, when we are going to study this Faraday's equation or Faraday's law, we should understand the two terms. First one that is a free space and second one that is a isotropic source. So isotropic source means what? So on your screen you can observe that here we have an antenna, okay, which radiates the energy. Okay, so in the diagram you can observe that we have the three axes x, y and z. Okay, and this the center point is nothing but we called it as a isotropic source. So isotropic source is nothing but such a source who radiates the energy in all direction. Isotropic source is nothing but it is such a type of source who radiate the energy equally in all directions, right? So you have to understood this. Means here it is the point source of radiation which radiates the equally in all directions. Is what I mean to say that this is such a source who radiates the energy equally. So this word is very important. Which one? Equally, because in all direction it will radiate the same amount of energy. Same amount of energy means in simple language, it radiates the electromagnetic waves in all the direction who are having the equal energy, right? So now this is the second thing. So here we discuss about free space and second one, this is a isotropic source. So free space is clear, isotropic source is clear. You have to remember that isotropic source is nothing but it is such a source who radiates the energy equally in all direction. Because when we are talking about the antenna, the direction factor is very important. Okay, directional antenna and non-directional antenna. So this is a non-directional antenna. Okay, so it will radiate the energy equally in all the direction. Now this is such type of source is known as a isotropic source. Okay, now the third term, that is a power density. So power density is nothing but it is the amount of energy. It is the amount of energy which is radiated by isotropic source. It is the amount of energy means in previous diagram here you can observe that we have the different arrows. So now I want to find out the energy at this point. Okay, so if I want to find out the energy at this point, so how I will calculate? So first I have to find out the power density. Okay, so how we are going to find out the power density? So first we should know what do you mean by power density. So power density is nothing but it is the radiated power per unit area, right? Is it clear? What do you mean by power density? Power density is defined as it is a radiated power per unit area of isotropic source. So we know that. What do you mean by isotropic source? So isotropic source is nothing but it is such a source who radiates the energy equally in all the direction. Okay, so if it will radiate the energy in one direction, so from one direction we cannot calculate the power density of that source, right? So first we have to understood that a power density is nothing but it will radiate the energy equally in all the direction, right? So now the third term is the power density. It is the radiated power per unit area. So now how you are going to calculate this one? So here PT is nothing but it is a total power, and this pi r square. Okay, so this pi r square is nothing but it is a total area. Means if you observe in previous diagram, so in this diagram it is nothing but it is a circle, and we know the formula for the circle, that is a 4 pi r square. So with this formula we can calculate the area, and this power density, which is denoted by P average. So P average is nothing but it is a total power divided by 4 pi r square, right? And here power is measured in watt and area is measured in meter per square, right? So this is the formula to calculate the power density of isotropic source. Okay, so now this is the formula to calculate the isotropic source. So here what is the P average? It is the power density. What is PT? It is the total power. And what is the what is this 4 pi r square? It is nothing but it is the total area, and the unit of this power density is nothing but it is a watt per meter square. Okay, so three terms we already seen. What is free space? Second one, that is the isotropic source, and third one, that is the power density, right? So there will be a question, why there is need to study all these three? That is the power density, isotropic source, and this free space. Because when we want to study the Faraday's equation, these three terms are very important. Okay, or these Faraday's, or either in a simple language, we can say that the Faraday's equation gives the relationship between these three. Okay, so now this is the electromagnetic waves. Now we will see actual Faraday's equation. So this is nothing but it is an electromagnetic wave. Okay, so here in this diagram, this K is nothing but it is showing the direction of propagation. Okay, in which direction? Means, and this is the, we can here we can call it as this is nothing but it is a source. Okay, and electromagnetic wave is propagated in this direction, Z direction. Okay, now here we have the two fields. That is, the one is a electric field and another one is a magnetic field. We know that electric field is perpendicular to the magnetic field. So these red lines here, you can find out this EX. So these red lines are nothing but which shows the electrical energy or electrical field. These blue lines are nothing but it is a magnetic field, and this K is nothing but it is a direction of propagation, right? So here these things which are related with the electromagnetic waves. Now we have to find out the equation. Okay, Faraday's equation. So in Faraday's equation, again one more important factor is that there is an effective aperture or effective area. Okay, so first of all, what is the use of this Faraday's equation? So this Faraday's equation is nothing but which is used to calculate the path loss. Okay, or it will give the relationship between the transmitted power and received power. Okay, so that we will see afterwards. So first you have to understood in this diagram. So here we can observe an antenna. Here we have an antenna. Okay, and here this antenna is receiving some amount of power. Okay, means we can call it as, this is nothing but it is a this is a receiver antenna, right? This is the receiver antenna, and this receiver antenna is receiving the some amount of power which is transmitted by, so suppose here somewhere we have some transmitter antenna. So this transmitter antenna radiates some amount of power. So when this antenna receives this power, okay, so if we want to find out the relationship between this transmitted power, that is PT, and this received power, that is PR. So here, if we want to find out the relationship between this transmitted power and received power, so what I can say, effective area is very important. Means this transmitter radiates the power towards this receiver antenna, but depending upon the focused surface of this antenna, we can calculate the received power. If the area is more, then we will receive the more amount of power. If the area is less, then we will receive the less amount of power. And one more important factor is that it will not only depend upon the area or surface, it will also depend upon the power density. Okay, so in previous slide we already discussed about the power density. So power density is nothing but here we know that it is the power density is nothing but it is the total divided total power divided by 4 pi r square. Okay, so here here the total received power is depend upon the surface area as well as the power density. So here in this diagram, in this equation, this PR is nothing but it is a received power, right? So this received power is nothing but it is an integration of this P average. What is the P average? It is nothing but it is a power density, and ds is nothing but it is the surface area, right? So here we can say that PR is nothing but P average S. Okay, so the total power density here, or average power density of incoming wave, average power density of incoming wave is nothing but it is P average into S. So I think this is clear, okay, how to calculate the received power, right? Now here, how much power is captured from a given plane, a given plane wave? Okay, so P is nothing but power divided by area, and here PT is nothing but it is the total transmitted power, just I showed you, right? So if we want to find out the relationship between these two, so this relationship between these two is nothing but here, just a minute. The relationship between this one is nothing but it is a total power divided by this power density into effective area, right? So here effective area, or it is also known as the effective aperture. So this effective aperture is nothing but it is denoted by AE equal to lambda square divided by 4 pi into G. So here lambda is nothing but it is a wavelength, lambda is nothing but it is a wavelength, and this 4 pi is nothing but it is the area, and G is nothing but it is the gain. Okay, now here in this diagram we can observe three terms, that is the total power, okay, power received power, and this is the effective area. So what is the significance of this Faraday's equation? So Faraday's equation is nothing but it will give the relationship between all these three. So here you can find out the what is the exact relation. So this is the transmitter antenna, this one, okay, this is the transmitter antenna, and here we have the this is the transmitter antenna, here we have the receiver antenna. Transmitted power is a PT, received power is a PR. Okay, so this GT is nothing but it is the gain of transmitter antenna, right? And this AE is nothing but we already seen what is AE in previous slide. AE is nothing but it is the effective area of receiving antenna. It is the effective area of receiving antenna. Okay, and this P is nothing but rho is nothing but we know that it is, this is nothing but it is the power density. So here this rho is equal to Pt divided by 4 pi r square that we already seen. Okay. Now when we are talking about the gain, if we will consider the gain of this transmitter antenna, so in that scenario, this is nothing but Pt divided by 4 pi r square into Gt. So this Gt is nothing but it is a gain of transmitter antenna. And here, if we want to calculate the total received power at this point, so received power is nothing but it is the total transmitted power, this one, that is divided by the area, and Gt is nothing but it is a transmit, it is a gain of transmitter, and this A is nothing but it is the effective area. Okay, so this equation, so the equation which gives the amount of received power at the receiving antenna is nothing but we call it as the Faraday's equation, right? So is it clear? So what Faraday's equation gives? Faraday's equation gives the amount of received power, and this PR is equal to nothing but it is a PT into this is PT is nothing but total power, GT is nothing but it is the gain of transmitter antenna, GR is nothing but it is a gain of receiving antenna. Okay, so here we know that A is AE. What you can this is the same formula, but here you can observe the lambda square. So what I did is simply instead of AE. So in previous slide we seen that A is nothing but it is a lambda square divided by 4 pi g, and g is the directive gain. Okay, simply I will put this value in this formula. So then this formula will become PR is equal to PT into GT divided by GR lambda square divided by 4 pi r square bracket square. Okay, so this formula is nothing but we called it as the Faraday's transmission formula, right? So I think in today's lecture we will discuss about the Faraday's equation, and I hope that you understood this, right? Is it clear? Okay. So again, samajh mein. Now we have only I think 2-3 minutes are left. So can you tell me when we are going to study the Faraday's equation? Which are the important factor we supposed to understood? Yes, anybody can you tell me? Pooja, can you tell me? Agar Faraday's equation humko padhna hai, so which are the important factor? Yaar, which are the parameter we supposed to be consider? Yes. Ravi, kya bata sakte ho? ये कौन कौन से इंपॉर्टेंट
पावर डेंसिटी
वेरी गुड और पावर डेंसिटी फ्री स्पेस है ना आइसोट्रोपिक सोर्स दैट ट्रांसमिटर एंटीना गेन रिसीवर एंटीना गेन इफेक्टिव एरिया ऑफ रिसीवर एंटीना ओके And with the help of all this, if you will find out the relationship between all these things, so then we will get the Faraday's equation, right? So इसको और डिटेल में हम पढ़ेंगे, which is जिसमें कि पार्ट क्लास वगैरह होगा, so that we will see in next lecture. Okay? So I think you got because this is the main formula in when we are talking about the electromagnetic wave transmission. कोई भी type का electromagnetic wave transmission लो. उसका बेस फंडामेंटल बेस विल बी Faraday's फॉर्मूला विच गिव द रिसीव पावर ऑफ द एंटीना राइट आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड ऑल दिस थिंग्स सो टुडे वी विल स्टॉप हियर ओके थैंक्स फॉर अटेंडिंग द लेक्चर सो विल स्टॉप हियर